Hello dear student, so today we'll start our new grammar chapter, that is contractions. You must be knowing about contractions and you might have used most of time exactly what contractions are. So in short, I can say that contractions are short forms of the particular words or a group of words, I can say. Example, like where I'm saying that he is a boy. When I'm saying he is a boy, so I'll just make a short, he is a boy. So he is, I'll make short, is not can be made isn't. Alright. So there are different forms of contractions are there and we use it in English. And such short forms are called as contractions. So you can see just in front of you that there are some definitions of contractions. So a contraction is a shortened version of written and spoken forms of word, syllable it can be, or even a word or a group. And all the contractions are created by omission, means to remove that, by internal letters and sounds. So when we remove the internal letter, inside letter, it is called as contraction here. And in simple way, we can say that the process of shortening a word is known as contractions. So example, I am given here, is and not. So here we may get isn't. So N is there plus apostrophe we have put it, and T, the symbol where my arrow is called apostrophe. Alright. And R not is the full form. Then shortened word, contraction, we make it in this way, aren't. Okay, A R E N apostrophe and T. So word O is omitted here, and here letter O is also omitted. Alright, so this is what about contractions. Now there are some criteria, some common rules that we can note about these contractions. So contraction is one word made up from two words. Like there are two words, are and not. Okay, but when we combine them, we make it only one word, aren't. Then first word usually stays the same. Whatever the first word is there, is, are, have, they are same only, but the second letter is changed. And certain letter are taken out of the second word. So from second word, certain words, it's not specific rule there. Sometime we remove the beginning letters, sometime we remove the middle letters. And wherever we miss the letter, we remove the letter, and apostrophe will fill the space of the missing letter. So on that place we'll be giving apostrophe there. All right and there are some forms of contraction, the contraction of the verb forms. Like most of the time we use some major contraction, like the verbs which are often contracted, we can see here, like am is there, is, are, and has, have, had, will, and would. So these verbs, auxiliary verbs, helping verbs are made shortened most of time. You can see the usual form is one column here and contracted form. So just am used. So I will use I am. Okay. Then he is on this he is. This he and apostrophe s. Then are. First a we have removed and this they are. So they are. Alright. Then here has. So he has. And time will remove H and A and just put apostrophe. For have, what will do? Dev. Dev. So here H and A will remove and will put apostrophe and will we and he will use. At the same time, we have had also. In this, H A is removed and D is used. And for will, we'll just use he will. He'll. Alright. So apostrophe will put and W and I will remove. And here whole four letters W O A L, all four letters are removed and only D is there. So had and would, you may face some problem because the contraction will be same. So dear student, you also need to practice these letters. Wherever you see them, whenever you can read the book, at that time you see most of the short forms. Alright. And these short forms are nothing but we call them contractions. Alright. So what you will do, you can have a look in your textbook at any chapter, any lesson, and from that note down some contractions, and after taking out the contraction, write their full form also. Alright, so that will be better idea for you and better practice for you, so that you can simply identify and change the contraction as well. Alright, so there are some points to remember and ponder. I have written a new word here. Ponder means to think, to wonder about some thoughts. So look at that, what the first rule is. If S, so apostrophe S, is followed by an adjective or the ing form of verb. So if it is followed by an adjective or by the ing form of verb, it is the contracted form of is. Alright, so that is like he is happy, we have to use, because adjective you have said, okay, he is happy or he is reading. So when we are using this example, you can see here, he is happy. So here he is happy. So when this is will be used, when there is an adjective after this, when there is adjective after is, the first thing. Second thing, this contraction will be is when there is ing verb form. Look at here, ing form of verb. So she is reading. So you may have confusion in the has word and is word. So when there is an adjective after the s verb, it means it is. After the apostrophe s, if there is ing verb form, it is an also example of is only. So she is reading, it is example of present continuous tense. She is reading a book. Alright, then we have second rule here. If apostrophe s is followed by the past participle form of a verb, okay, if this s is followed by past participle form of verb, means vitri form, so it is the contract form of has. So if there is vitri form after has, definitely an example of has only. So there has will come, is will not come. I cannot say that he has happy, no, or I even cannot say that he is come. Alright, so these sentences are wrong. So we need to get careful about the idea where has will come and where his will come. So has will come when there is a v3 form after that, and happy adjective and reading ing verb will come, there will be is. So look at this, he has come, he has come, that's the first sentence, and she has gone to school. Alright, so she has gone to school. Look at here, come also with three form, come, came and come, and here go, went and gone. So both the verbs are in v3 form here, verb third form, and for that purpose this apostrophe s will be has. Okay, so the meaning of contraction and how to do it, I hope dear student you have understood that. So practice more to find out more contractions and make their full form and short form also, so that it will not be carrying any doubt in your mind. Okay, so thank you so much dear student, have a wonderful day, practice more, study well.